Good morning, everyone. I hope you all are safe at your home. So, this video is for the students of class 7th subject English. In this video, we shall read our lesson number 4, that is, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom, from our book Honeycomb, and this is my lecture number 2. So, our chapter name is The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. Main characters in the story are Muko, who was a dog, a kind old couple, and wicked neighbors. So, in my last video, I already told you that this chapter is divided in 2 parts. And in our last video, we read a part 1. Let's have a look on summary of part 1. There lived an old couple. They had a pet dog. They loved it as if it were their baby. The old man was a rice farmer and was followed by his pet to the fields. One day, the dog has taken the man to a spot and began scratching the earth there. The man digs the earth and found a pile of gold. They became rich and bought a piece of land. They gave a feast to their friends and did charity to their poor friends. In contrast to the kind and sensitive couple, there lived an insensitive couple. That insensitive couple used force to take the dog to a place where they could find some place to dig gold. The dog befooled them and began scratching at a place where a dead kitten was buried. Angrily, the old man killed the dog and his wife nearly chopped off his head with a sharp hoe. Then, they buried his carcass or dead body into the soil and made a heap of earth over it. The old people regretted the severance with the dog and mourned his death. Then one day when the old man was sleeping, the spirit of the dog appeared in his dreams and asked him to cut the pure tree near his grave. It wanted him to make a mortar or bowl for his rice pastry and a mill for bean sauce. The old man followed the wish of the dog. When New Year's time was around, he decided to make rice pastry. When the rice was boiled and it was poured into the mortar, the old man lifted the hammer to pound or crush into the dough. To his surprise, it changed into a heap of gold coins. The same thing happened with the old woman when she poured beans to a handmill. Gold started dripping like rain. The jealous neighbors were watching everything, so they came to borrow the mortar or bowl and the magic mill. But their pastry turned out to be a foul mass of worms, and they were furious or angry, and they cut the mill into pieces and used it for firewood. This was the summary of a part 1 that we read in our lecture number 1. Now in this lecture, we shall read a part 2. Not long after that, the good old man dreamed again, and the spirit of the dog spoke to him, telling him how the wicked people had burned the mill made from the pine tree. Now, again the old good man dreamed about the dog. And this time the dog in his dream told him how the wicked people had broken the mill and now how they are using the broken pieces of mill in the firewood. Take the ashes of the mill, sprinkle them on the withered or dry trees, and they will bloom again, said the dog spirit. Now this time, what did the dog say to the old man in his dream? He said that, take the ashes of the mill from that wicked couple's house and then sprinkle those ashes on the withered tree or on the dry trees and they will bloom again. The old man awoke and went at once to his wicked neighbor's house, where he found the miserable old pair sitting at the edge of their square fireplace in the middle of the floor smoking and spinning. Now, after dreaming about the spirit of the dog and listening to what dog wants him to do, the old man awoke. And then he went to the wicked neighbor's house where he saw that the old pair was sitting near the fireplace and in the middle of the floor and they were smoking and spinning. From time to time they warmed their hands and feet with the blaze from some bits of the mill, while behind them lay a pile of the broken pieces. Now what happened when the old kind man reached the wicked couple's house? He saw that they were sitting in front of the fireplace and they were warming their hands and feet. And in the fireplace, they were putting the pieces of the mill, and some of the pieces of the mill were lying behind them. The good old man humbly asked for the ashes, though the covetous or jealous couple turned up their noses at him and scolded him as if he were a thief. They let him fill his basket with the ashes. Now what happened when the old good man reached their house, the wicked couple's house? He asked them for the ashes as asked by the spirit of the dog. But what happened, instead of giving him the ashes quietly, the jealous couple turned up their noses and they also scolded him as he was a thief. But at the end, they let him fill his basket with the ashes of the mill. On coming home, the old man took his wife into the garden. It being winter, their favorite cherry tree was bare. Now, after taking ashes of the mill from the wicked couple's house, he came home. On coming home, he took his wife to his garden, to the garden where their favorite cherry tree was bare. It was all dry. There were no flowers on that cherry tree. He sprinkled a pinch of ashes on it, and lo, it sprouted blossoms of flowers until it became a cloud of pink blooms or flowers which perfumed the air. Now what happened when the old man took ashes? He came to the garden with his wife and he sprinkled a pinch of ashes on the cherry tree, which was their favorite tree and which was completely bare. There were no flowers on that tree, but when the old kind man sprinkled a pinch of ashes on it, it sprouted blossoms. There were so many pink flowers on that tree, and that tree was spreading perfume in the air. That tree was spreading happiness in the air. The news of this filled the village and everyone ran out to see the wonder. Now, everyone was so excited to see the magic created by the spirit of the dog, or we can say created by the old kind man, or we can say created by the ashes of the mill. Now, the covetous or jealous couple also heard the story, and gathering up the remaining ashes of the mill, kept them to make withered trees blossom. Now, when the story or when this news filled the village and everyone heard about this story, the jealous couple also heard the story. And on hearing the story, what they did, they went to their house and they collected all the remaining ashes from their fireplace. And they kept those ashes to make dry trees blossom. The kind old man, hearing that, his lord, the daimyo. Daimyo is a title given to a person as an owner because of something special that he or she has done. So, the kind old man came to know that his lord, the daimyo, was to pass along the high road near the village, set out to see him, taking his basket of ashes. On hearing the news of arrival of his lord, he set out to see him, taking his basket of ashes in his hand. As the train approached, he climbed up into an old withered tree, cherry tree, that stood by the wayside. Now, on hearing the news of arrival of his lord, what the old kind man did, he climbed up a old dry cherry tree that was near the train. Now, in the days of the daimyos, means in the days of those land or wealthy landowners, it was the custom when their lord passed by for all the loyal people to shut up their high windows. Now, it was the custom in Japan that whenever their lord passed by, they have to shut their windows, okay? They even pasted them fast with a slip of paper so as not to commit the impertinence, or we can say rudeness, of looking down on his lordship. All the people along the road would fall upon their hands and knees and remain prostrate. Prostrate is a body posture in which a person lies on the ground and his face is downward until the procession, or we can say the train, passed by. The train drew near. Now, what was their custom? According to their custom, whenever their lord passed by, they have to sit on the ground and they have to sit on their knees and they have to make keep their faces downward towards the ground. One tall, competent man marched ahead, crying or saying out to the people by the way, "Get down on your knees. Get down on your knees." And everyone kneeled down while the procession or train was passing. Now, what happened? Along with the daimyo, there was a man whose job was to say again and again to people, "Get down on your knees, get down on your knees." And everyone kneeled down while the train of daimyo passed. Suddenly, the leader of the van caught sight of the aged man up in the tree. He was about to call out to him in an angry tone, but seeing he was such an old fellow, he pretended not to notice him and passed him by. Now, as I told you that the old kind man climbed a withered cherry tree, now he was noticed by the leader of the van. He was just about to call him in an angry tone, but then he thought that he was such an old fellow, so he pretended as if he has not noticed him or if he has not seen him and passed him by. So when the daimyo's palanquin, or the we can say van, when the daimyo's van drew near, the old man, taking a pinch of ashes from his basket, scattered it over the tree. In a moment, it burst into blossom. Now, what happened? When the daimyo's van drew near, what the old man did? He took a pinch of ashes from his basket and he sprinkled those ashes on that withered tree, on that dry tree. And in a moment, that dry tree was burst into blossom, into flowers, into pink flowers. The delighted or happy Daimyo ordered the train to be stopped and got out to see the wonder. Now, as we know that wonder was created by the ashes of the mill, he was very happy. Daimyo was very happy and he ordered the train to be stopped. And he get out of his train to see how the magic happened. Calling the old man to him, he thanked him and ordered presents of silk robes, sponge cakes, fans and other rewards to be given him. Now the Daimyo was so impressed that he gave so many rewards to that old man. He even invited him to his castle. So the old man went gleefully or happily home to share his joy with his dear old wife. Now, along with giving so many rewards, Daimyo also invited the old man to his kingdom, to his castle. So, the old man was so happy and he went to his home to share his happiness with his dear old wife. But when the greedy neighbor heard of it, he took some of the magic ashes and went out on the highway. Now, the greedy neighbor couple also heard about the magic and also heard that Daimyo rewarded the old kind man. On hearing this, what he did, he took some of the magic ashes with him and he went out on the highway. There, he waited until a Daimyo's train came along and instead of kneeling down like the crowd, he climbed a withered cherry tree. Now he also copied the old man and he also climbed the dry tree instead of kneeling down. When the Daimyo himself was almost directly under him, he threw a handful of the ashes over the tree, which did not change a particle. Now when Daimyo came near, what that wicked man did, he threw a handful of ashes over the tree. But nothing happened. There was no magic this time. The wind blew the fine dust in the noses and eyes of the Daimyo and his wife. Now the opposite happened. Instead of blooming the tree, the ashes went into the noses and eyes of the Daimyo and his wife. Such sneezing and choking, it spoiled all the pomp and dignity of the procession, or we can say of the train. The man whose business it was to cry or to say, "Get down on your knees," seized or caught the old fool by the collar and dragged him from the tree and tumbled him and his ash basket into the ditch by the road. Now, the man whose business was to say again and again, "Get down on your knees," he caught the old fool and he dragged him down from the tree. Then, beating him soundly, he left him for dead. And that man beated the wicked old man so badly and left him for dying. Thus, the wicked old man died in the mud, but the kind friend of the dog dwelt in peace and plenty, and both he and his wife lived to a green old age, to a healthy, active and prosperous life. Now, when the man whose job was to cry again and again that, or whose job was to say again and again that, "Get down on your knees," he brought that man, that wicked old man, from the tree and he beat him so badly that he died in the mud. But the kind friend of the dog was in peace and was living a active, prosperous and very healthy life. So this chapter teaches us that people are known by their deeds. just as a tree is known by its leaves and fruits. People and animals will all be kind to us if we are kind to them. But being mean or wicked usually makes us less happy. So, from this chapter, we learned that we should be happy and we should be kind to everyone. So, this was a lecture number 2 in which we read part 2 of our lesson number 4, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. I hope you understood it. In our next video, we shall revise the complete chapter again. So, your homework is you have to read part 2 of your lesson 4, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom, and then you have to do given question answers. So, these question answers are given on page number 63 under the heading Working with the Text. Answer the following questions. The first question is, the old farmer is a kind person. What evidence of his kindness do you find in the first 2 paragraphs? The second question is, what did the dog do to lead the farmer to the hidden gold? I repeat, what did the dog do to lead the farmer to the hidden gold? Third, first part, how did the spirit of the dog help the farmer first? How did the spirit of the dog help the farmer first? How did it help him next? How did it help him next? The fourth question is, why did the daimyo reward the farmer but punish his neighbor for the same act? I repeat, why did the daimyo reward the farmer but punish his neighbor for the same act? Now we are going to discuss our homework solution of lesson 4, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom, lecture number 1. So, first of all, open your fair notebooks, make a proper format, draw margin, write down lesson number 4 and write down the name of the chapter, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. And after that, write down the heading word meanings. The first word is snug, its meaning is comfortable. The second word is ashes, its meaning is burnt powder. The third word is gleamed, its meaning is glittered. The fourth word is on purpose, its meaning is intentionally. Fifth word is dainties, its meaning is tasty food. Sixth word is flung, its meaning is threw. Seventh word is covetous, its meaning is greedy or jealous. Eighth word is carcass, its meaning is dead body. Ninth word is pound, its meaning is crush. The 10th word is mortar, its meaning is bowel. 11th word is withered, its meaning is dry. 12th word is gleefully, its meaning is happily. 13th word is seized, its meaning is caught. 14th word is stingy, its meaning is miserably. Our first question was given on page number 60 under comprehension check. Question number 1 was, why did the neighbors kill the dog? I repeat, why did the neighbors kill the dog? The answer is, the neighbors killed the dog because he did not give any treasure to them. I repeat, the neighbors killed the dog because he did not give any treasure to them. The second question is, mark the right item. First part, The old farmer and his wife loved the dog. A. Because it helped them in their day-to-day work. B. As if it was their own baby. Or C. As they were kind to all living beings. Its answer is B part. The old farmer and his wife loved the dog as if it was their own baby. I repeat, the answer is B part. The old farmer and his wife loved the dog as if it was their own baby. The second part of the question is, when the old couple became rich, they A. gave the dog better food, B. invited their greedy neighbors to a feast, or C. lived comfortably and were generous towards their poor neighbors. The answer is C part. When the old couple became rich, they lived comfortably and were generous towards their poor neighbors. I repeat, the answer is C part. When the old couple became rich, they lived comfortably and were generous towards their poor neighbors. The third part of the question is, the greedy couple borrowed the mill and the mortar to make A part, rice pastry and bean sauce, B, magic ash to win rewards, or C, a pile of gold. The answer is C part. The greedy couple borrowed the mill and the mortar to make a pile of gold. The answer is C part. The greedy couple borrowed the mill and the mortar to make a pile of gold. So this was all about today's video. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, then please like the video and subscribe our channel.